Hi guys, I am Rishit Shah from Tally School, and in this video we are going to look at advanced against ref, new ref, on account, and what all this mean actually in Tally. So to give you a little bit of idea of what this is that it is a bill book. It is a digital bill book in Tally. So if we create a manual bill book, we create a separate bill for a separate sale or a separate invoice for a separate sale, and in that bill book we give separate numbers which are called bill number or invoice number, and by that way we have the bill book or we create the entire bill book, and most of the times those numbers are pre-numbered, and that is what is also now applicable in GST also. So how you can use this bill by bill details for GST as well as in Tally for better accounting in Tally. So these all terms are related to that is maintaining bill wise details in Tally. You can see here bill wise details for Amazon. So if I sell something on Amazon or you sell something to anyone, any party, then we create an invoice for that in Tally, which is called voucher. But if we have not enabled bill-wise details, then what will happen is Tally will not create a list according to the invoice numbers or bill numbers or voucher numbers or reference numbers. They all mean the same in Tally. Tally will create different vouchers for different sales, but Tally will not create another list for different bill numbers or according to bill-wise details. In Tally it will not create. So how you can enable that, let me just show you. First, that I am in Amazon. This is the ledger for Amazon for sundry debtors. You can have any ledger for anyone under sundry debtors or sundry creditors, and you can maintain bill wise details in Tally. So there is an option called maintain balances bill by bill. You have to select it to yes and then press Ctrl plus A to accept. You can also add these options, but if you do not want to add these options, then it's okay. Just select this to yes and click on accept. So as soon as you click on accept, and when you go to receipt voucher, I am actually in the receipt voucher right now, or a payment voucher, you will see this kind of details. So if I just go back, I am in the receipt voucher and I have selected on the credit side Amazon, because I've sold goods on Amazon or I've sold goods to a party. He is my sundry debtor. And now I am going to receive money from him. So that's why the receipt voucher, and selected the party, which is Amazon. Press enter and you will see bill wise details for Amazon. So what this means is you have to enter the money that you received from Amazon against the bill which you received. So for example, if I sold something to you for 1,000 rupees and the bill number for that was, let's say, 11, then I can enter that in Tally that I have received 1000 rupees from you against that particular bill number. How this is useful? This is useful if you are using due date or credit system in your business, then it is very useful, because you can track that in how many days you received the money. By that you can track the aging, and by that you can track how much working capital you actually need in the business. That's a little bit advanced, but a good way is to track how money you received in your business and against which invoice. This is also a good way to keep the accounting better, because let's say you are dealing with a party and you are receiving money, you are selling goods, you are receiving money and you are selling goods. Everything is on credit. So you are selling goods and you are receiving money. So let's say you sold goods worth 10 lakhs in a month to a particular party, and the total bills that you've generated were 10, but the party at the end of the month gave you 10 lakh, or he gave you 5 lakhs this month, then 5 lakhs next month against the 10 bills. So now you can track that in Tally as well, that against which invoice or against which bill you received the money. So that's what this is all about. It's a digital bill book in Tally. You can say that if we create a bill book in manual form or write bills, it's a digital bill book. So against ref, advance, new ref, and on account. On account is simply on account of the creditor or debtor. So if you do not want to mess with the bills, then you just simply select on account and there will be no option for name of the bill. So directly on account of the debtor, so directly on account of the Amazon. Then advance means when you receive advance from your debtor or when you give advance to the creditor, that is advance. So if you click on advance, a separate number is created and due date is automatically entered on the basis of what you have selected during the creation or alteration of the ledger for Amazon or the party that you are selling to or buying from. So advance is used when you receive advance, when you are selling, and when you give advance, when you are buying. Then against ref is used when you are receiving money. Right now we are receiving money because we are in the receipt voucher. I have shown that to you. And then you can use that against ref means against which bill you are receiving money. So if I press on against ref, Tally will display all the pending bills. Now it displays all the pending bills. That means that if you are selling to someone and you are buying from the same party, it will display all the bills. You can see here credit, which means I bought from Amazon, and two balances are debit, which means I've sold to Amazon. So I can select this bill number 1 and 11,200 amount and press enter, and Tally will pick up everything from there. So this is how against ref is used. It just simply means that you are receiving money against a particular invoice in Tally, and you can track that in Tally. Now what is new ref? New ref simply means a new number that you have created. So it creates another new number, and you can enter that in Tally as well, that it is a new reference number or a new number for which you are receiving the money. That means it creates a new invoice number in Tally. So generally what is used is against ref. So let's say I've sold something to Amazon which was around 11,200 rupees, and the name, that is the reference number, is 1, or invoice number or voucher number is 1. So I've selected that, and credit, and end of the list. Then debit bank or cash, whatever the way you receive the money, press enter and enter all these details and save it. So this is how against ref and new ref, that is against reference number, new reference number, advance, and on account works in Tally. The best way to use this is enable the bill wise details in all the sundry creditors and sundry debtors ledgers, and then when you receive the money or pay the money, you will see the list. Then against that list, you select that I am receiving money or paying money against this particular bill. That way you will have a track that you are paying money for this much bills. Otherwise, when you pay money in lump sum or receive money in lump sum, you have to manually check that for how many bills we have received the money or we are paying the money. So that's the use of bill wise details in Tally, or we can say against ref or advance ref in Tally. So that's it for this video. If you have liked this video, then subscribe to Tally School. I am uploading videos daily. As far as possible, I am uploading videos even on Sundays. So please subscribe to Tally School, and if you have any questions or suggestions that, or you want me to make a video for your question on Tally, then please comment down below and I'll create a video for you as well. So thank you very much for watching, and subscribe to Tally School, like this video, because that's how I know that you have actually liked the video. Thank you very much for watching, and see you in the next video.